Because cypress trees, you know, you got the dwarf cypress out in the open, you see, that are growing areas. They got to have some kind of water. They thrive in water. And they drink up a lot of, they uptake a lot of water. And so when you see how things are running, the channels in there, for me, not being a scientist, just being an Indian out in the woods, you know, I would think that the water went this way. And you can see the water lines on the base of the cypress tree, right? About an idea of how deep it gets up in here. You see the watermark.
Mm-hmm.
And you see those ferns and stuff growing on top of that watermark. Because those are stuff that needs to be out of, it needs water, but it needs to be out of the water to thrive. So, and you'll notice those changes. And here, I know, when back in this area, we're going to get closer to when we go around the bend. And here, way back when, before all, you had 41 and all that, I remember my grandma talked about back up in here, the manatees would come all the way up in here.
Wow.
To figure really? Out. So if a manatee is coming up in here, that tells me there's got to be some kind of channel, waterway it's following. Mm-hmm. To get up here, because they used to talk about hunting the manatee off Loop Road. Oh. So apparently we have altered it so much that the manatees can't travel this far inland anymore, but they used to. So we heard stories that they hunt manatee. And once in a while you see big old, when I was a teenager, one of my brothers got like a 7-foot tarpon up in here.
Lord.
So, you know, tarpon, you know, it's like, how did a tarpon get over mm-hmm. here, you know? Mm-hmm. So there had to be that connection in your water bodies coming from, you know, a salt water into fresh water to get saltwater fish up here. So if we've disrupted that, so when you think about trying to heal and make those reconnections, how can you reconnect that balance where those animals, like the manatee, needed that warm water, right? When it's in the wintertime and all that, you see, that's why you see them at the power plants
mm-hmm.
and those cooling canals, because it's warm.
Mm-hmm.
So if historically those animals naturally were seeking further inland into the Everglades for fresh water, for warm water, we've cut them off from that. So we've displaced them from where they used to be in pursuit of, you know, whatever grand dreams people had. You know, when you look at, when I mentioned nature needs to speak, when you think back, the manatees used to be here, so we've displaced the manatee. You know, and sometimes they talk about once in a while you get crocodiles. I've never seen a crocodile here, but I've heard stories that even crocodiles would come this far inland. So these animals that had history coming here, we've displaced them from that area. Just like today, we're displacing human beings as well, right? Because when we alter where they live. And how can we find that, you know, balance? And you see the moss up there. For us, the moss has different uses. I don't know what other people use it for, but we use it like used to be a bedding.